بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. صفيه بن عبد المطلب, may Allah be pleased with her. She was the prophet's paternal aunt, a daughter of his maternal aunt, the mother of Jubair ibn al-Awwam and Hamza ibn Abd al-Muttalib's full sister. It was said that she was the prophet's only maternal aunt who embraced Islam and migrated. She had a strong personality and she was inclined to sternness and harshness. But how? Her first marriage was to Al-Harith ibn Umayyah, Abu Sufyan's brother. He then died and there was no children between them. She was then married to Al-Awwam ibn Khuwaylid, Khadija's brother, to whom she bore Az-Zubayr and As-Sayyid. So when he died, Safiya devoted all her attention to her two orphaned sons, especially the younger one. Whenever he came home complaining from the bullying of his age mate, she would sternly rebuke him, tie him and beat him up. When one of the members of her husband's family passed by her while she was treating her son in that way, he requested her to be kind to the poor orphan. She told the man that she wanted to make a man out of her son, a man that would be undefeatable and insuppressible, a man that would never surrender to any of Allah's creatures. It was reported that Az-Zubayr engaged in a duel with someone who slandered him, and Az-Zubayr broke the hand of the slanderer and severely beat him up. The beaten man in his pain was brought to Safiya and she asked of what happened to him, and she was told, he fought with Az-Zubayr and he did to him what you are seeing. When she heard that, she proudly recited a poetry verse saying, how did you find Zubayr? Did you find him a cottage cheese or a date fruit? Or you find him a raving falcon? He is not as simple to overcome or an easy food that be eaten effortlessly. Safiya achieved what she wanted, for Az-Zubayr grew strong in body and soul. He had a body that knew no pain or weakness, and a soul that knew no lassitude nor sluggishness. It is also said that Safiya did not embrace Islam until the day her brother did so, though her son Az-Zubayr had earlier embraced Islam, and that she used to fight him upon them. But Az-Zubayr had passed the stage of childhood to manhood then and became independent in his personality and opinion. She then had no control over him. He was, however, dutiful to her and compassionate with her. Safiya had many commendable and praiseworthy stances with the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the cause of promoting Islam. One of these is her stance during the Battle of the Trench, otherwise known as the Battle of the Confederate. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam put women and children in fortress for protection against the Confederates and the Jews of Banu Quraiza. Safiya was in a fortress known as Fari under the supervision of Asan ibn Thabit. Asan was assigned to look after the women and he did not go out to fight. of yourself. When the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam went out to the battle of the trench, he put the woman of his household in a fortress called Fari and assigned Hasan ibn Thabit to look after us. A Jewish man then came and climbed the fortress until he was able to see us. I asked Hasan to rise up and kill him, but he said that if he could do so, he would have been with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and would not have been assigned to look after the woman. I then rose up and killed him and cut his head off. I then asked Hasan to drag the head of the invader to the Jews who were at the bottom side of the fortress. He swore by Allah that he would not do so. So I took the head and threw it to them. The Jews then said, "We knew that this man," meaning the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "would not leave behind his family without someone to look after them." So they dispersed. Yunus ibn Bukhair said, "She was the first Muslim woman to kill a polytheist." Dear reader, with this tank of Safiya, we need no more proof of her strong personality in her faith, her defense of herself and her self-dignity. On the day of Uhud, she had more than one stand. When people felt defeated, she moved forward, and when people retreated, she advanced. Hammad narrated on the authority of Usam that Urwa said, "Safiya came on the day of the Battle of Uhud, while the Muslims were vanquished, holding a spear in her hand and striking with it the faces of the polytheists. When the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw her, he called her son to take hold of her left chibi arm, for she was his aunt. And Safiya heard of the martyrdom of her brother Hamza, whom she loved so much. She advanced to look at him and see how he was mutilated with a pierced open belly, a cut off nose and severed ears. Jubair stood in her way out of concern for her and told her, 'My mother, Allah's Messenger is ordering you to go back.' It is here that Safiya attained the peace of her stance and the personality of the strong and persevering believing woman vividly manifested. She told Jubair, 'Why should I go back, since I have heard that my brother was mutilated in the cause of Allah? We are not pleased with what happened, but I will bear it with patience, and I hope to get the reward from Allah, if He so wills.' Hajj Jubair came back to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and told him what she said. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam then said, 'Let her go.' She then came to Hamza and stood beside his corpse. She shed hot tears, sought Allah's forgiveness, and said, 'Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un.' And certainly we shall test you with something of fear, hunger, loss of wealth, life and fruit, but give glad tidings to Ashabirun, the patient, who, when afflicted with calamity, say, 'Truly to Allah we belong, and truly to Him we shall return.' They are those on whom are the salawat, that is, who are blessed and will be forgiven from their Lord, and they are those who receive His mercy, and it is they who are the guided ones." Quran chapter 2 ayat number 155 to 157. The above were exactly fit Safiya, for she did not utter a single word of eulogy except when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam died. At-Tabrani reported that when the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam died, Safiya came out waving her garment and saying, "Many occurrences have taken place after. If you were alive and had been witness to them, calamities would not have reached such a proportion." Ibn Ishaq reported some lines of poem with which Safiya eulogized the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. A part of it reads as follows: "The day we missed the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is here. O eyes, shed abundant and plentiful tears." She was also reported to have also said, "The day of your death is certainly a day in which the sun is wrapped up in darkness, though it is shining." None of the historians dispute attributing these poetic verses to Safiya. This is because she was known as a reciter of poetry, but not as a poet. Safiya lived till the time of the Caliphate of Umar, before Allah caused her to die. May Allah be pleased with her and please her.